just too rude. It's already been done, undo it. It takes two, it's up to me and you to prove it.
Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome IGC Show co-founder and Garden Chic publisher, Cheryl Morey.
Good morning, and welcome to the IGC Show. It's exciting to have you all here to be networking and sharing ideas and learning through the educational seminars, and of course, shopping the show floor. Without all of you, this would be for naught. So thank you for being here. You know, there are many challenges that we all face in our businesses, our personal lives, and as a country. And it's no secret that it's a tough economy. But we are tougher than the economy. We need to work smarter, and we need to work harder. And all of you are living examples of how those principles do produce success. It's not easy, but we're not alone in these struggles. There's one who chooses and desires to walk with us. Lord Jesus, you have provided each and every one of us a path to your perfect peace through your ultimate and perfect and selfless sacrifice. You have provided a foundation upon which we can have hope, wisdom, and the fortitude necessary to carry on, and more than that, to excel and be a light unto the world. Light of the world, thank you for your strength. Thank you for your provision. And thank you for all that you do for each and every one of us every day. Especially thank you for the miraculous, unseen way that you work in our lives. Blessed is your name, for your hand is upon our lives in ways we see and in ways we'll never know. For we walk by faith in the promise we have in you. Lord, let the weight of your glory rain down on us today. Let the life of your river flow. Bless those who are here with us today according to your portions. And Lord, God bless the USA.
Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome Chicago guitar legend Pistol Pete in this Jimi Hendrix-inspired version of our national anthem. Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome IGC show co-founder and nursery retailer publisher, Jeff Morey.
Wow. I always wanted to follow Jimi Hendrix on the stage. I mean, that's like one of my life's dreams. I always wanted to stand in a row of like 8 double-stack Marshalls, too. Isn't that something? Anyhow, welcome to IGC 2012. It's our 6th year. Can you believe it? It's been 6 years? It's been quite a trip. We have another exciting year, biggest show ever, some incredible keynotes. We have an incredible concert tomorrow night with Dennis DeYoung, the voice and main writing talent, and really the magic behind Styx. He'll put on an incredible show. So a lot going on. Just a reminder, a few housekeeping things here. For you GCA members, please pick up your GCA membership badge ribbons in the Garden Chic Lounge, and also your drink tickets for the Styx concert tomorrow night, Dennis DeYoung Styx concert tomorrow. So before we get into this morning's very interesting keynote, we have a interesting visual presentation here. Some of you probably are Apple guys like me, Mac guys, and you probably remember the famous 1984 Macintosh ad that ran, I think, just one time on the Super Bowl. Well, this little film put together by our wonderful sponsor, SMOMA, might remind you a bit of that. So let's take a look at that first. I didn't know Jim Hagedorn was speaking here this year. With that, I'd like to introduce my good friend, Bob Hartman, from the Spalma Company. Bob?
Thanks, Jeff.
Welcome to IGC.
Thank you. Thanks again, Jeff. You know, we're really honored to be sponsors of the keynote speaker today, but really what we're really excited about is the launch of our new organic lawn program. You know, this is something where everybody really wins. The consumers get a price point that's competitive with conventional lawn programs. Retailers can make up to 3 times the profit as they can on Big Brother's plan up there. And the lawns become safer for kids and pets, and that's really what we want to do now and in the future. So if any of that sounds interesting, please stop by the booth or visit espoma.com/IGC, and you can watch the video again, but we do have it at our booth as well. Anyway, enough about that. Let's get to the real reason why you're here, and it's not to listen to a sales pitch from me. The keynote speaker needs little or no introduction. He's a regular speaker on the lawn and garden circuit. I think his garden centers are ranked 18th on the top IGC 100. Prior to returning to the family business 16 years ago, he worked in sales and marketing for the Coca-Cola Company. He served on many committees, task forces, boards in our industry, and is a member of his local community foundation. He holds a degree in marketing from Michigan State and an MBA from the University of Minnesota. Please welcome to the stage the Executive Vice President of Bordines, Corey Bordine.
Good morning, IGC show! Hey, I'm over here, guys.
Just because somebody said welcome to the stage didn't mean that I'm a rule follower. I'm not on the stage yet. So let's try that again. I'd like a good morning, Corey, back. So one more time. Good morning, IGC show! There we go. That's a little bit better. We're awake. I like that. One thing that I always do in any talk I give, I make sure it's about interaction, because it's about networking. You're gonna see a lot of amazing speakers. You're gonna talk to a lot of incredible vendors. Hopefully you're gonna spend some money. But it's also about making contacts. And so the first thing that I'm gonna have you do here is you got to meet at least two people that you haven't met yet. You have 30 seconds, go. Two people you haven't met yet. All right, if you're not on your second person, you better be meeting that second person. Time is short. All right, begin to wrap that up. You are going to be working with and networking throughout the day. There are almost 1,000 people here in this auditorium. You're going to see that multiply as the day gets on because people are still coming into the show. You will learn as much from the peers around you as you will from the keynote speakers, as you will from the other vendors. Make sure you take that opportunity. The other thing I do with every talk that I give is I explain something. It's called the WAC. Who knows what the WAC is? Can you say that? Of course you're in the front row. Can you please stand up for me? Yes, you're the best. And what does the WAC stand for, Sally?
World According to Corey.
It stands for World According to Corey. That doesn't mean it's 100% right. It doesn't mean that I'm going to hit every single detail spot on. But what it does mean is for the next 40 minutes or so, I'm going to give you a perspective on business. And I'm going to use safari and animals as metaphors, but it is a world according to Corey. I hope that you will glean some key points from what I say, maybe not 100%, but that you'll understand that the world according to Corey does have some value. So with that, how's your business feel? It's 2012. Somebody said good right away. Who said that? Right there. Somebody said good. This was 2007. I don't think I would have had even one good. So how's your business feel, everybody, right now? Good, bad? A lot more good than bad. That's what we like to hear. Vendors, you like to hear that. That's a good sign. The Olympics just happened in the UK, and they did a brilliant job. Unbelievable. If America didn't love the British, we do now. Just absolutely amazing. All these pictures are from people just experiencing the thrill of victory in the Olympics. Unfortunately, with everything else, there's also the agony of defeat. These are also pictures from the Olympics. When you guys look at your business, you might have a little bit of each feeling going on. I would encourage you, especially if you're in a leadership role within your company, to make sure you emphasize the thrill of victory when you're looking towards spring of 2013. Because people are gonna feed off that. They're gonna feed off that positive energy. Make sure you think of the Olympics, you think about that thrill of victory as opposed to the agony of defeat. Things have changed. Again, we're gonna still stay across the pond really quickly, but things have changed over there. In England, this was gonna be the next Queen of England. Everybody knew it. Everybody loved her. Change happens. This is the next Queen of England. It's true. I wish I was making it up. I'm not. But that's the next Queen of England. Does change happen? It absolutely does. So we need to say goodbye to Diana and Sparkles. And well, Camilla, oops. Things have also changed in our world. Martha Stewart. Boy, she was our queen of the independent garden centers. You could watch her show and she would talk about individually placing that piece of seed in each little crevice of your garden and how you had to go out and hand cut everything and everything had to be unique and just, oh, I found this just amazing, incredible, scrumptious place to have dinner, and it came from all organic, and I found it at a little garden center. That's not Martha today. Our queen has changed. She still sells plants, but first, she went to prison. That was sort of a change. She did learn how to decorate.